I took the name Black Thought when I was 14 or 15 years old. Yeah, before I really understood, you know, what it could mean, right? Mm-hmm. What it could come to mean, or the power, you know, that it could that could lie within that name. And yeah, at the point in time, because I was a visual artist and just dealing with, you know, the palette and, you know, colors and mixing things. Yeah, I just came up with that, you know, the idea of Black Thought, in that it's the sort of thing that you think about the color black, or just, you know, on first, when first exposed to, first time you hear Black Thought, you might think, all right, black, it's a, it speaks to, you know, a lack of range, right? Or it speaks to a certain level of gravitas or militance, or you know, just, you know, just something, you know, other than being all expansive, mm-hmm. right? Which is the original place that it came from. Something all expansive, all inclusive, something that spoke to me as a creative, and that I didn't have any, you know, there was no particular style mm-hmm. that, you know, I was associated with, or that I would associate with myself as an artist. I wasn't like a, you know, I'm this type of emcee. But over time, yeah, it's something that, you know, has grown to mean, you know, far more, you know, to me and to my fans. You know, yeah, I think
what does it mean?
I mean, it has come to mean more, you know, just the concept of Black Thought. You know, it speaks to the idea of Black Thought, and yeah, you know, in black, you know, identity, my identity, our identity as a people. And as, you know, over the years, as I sort of grew to understand that that importance, and, you know, how much you know, my name and my work, and, you know, the Roots contribution, you know, meant to folks. It's the sort of thing that, you know, along with that came just a deeper level of responsibility, I guess.
Which you feel?
Yeah, I definitely feel it. Yeah, yeah.
And how did, I mean, in what way did you? In what way? I mean, how does it affect you?
I feel, you know, lots of responsibility. What, you know, some of those responsibilities are, you know, as a gatekeeper. You know, I'm one of, you know, the last, you know, of those ones, you know, so to speak. You know, as they say, the last of the Mohicans, mm-hmm. or whatever. You know, people who embrace the culture and understand it and have been around, you know, throughout in the way that I have, are few and far between. And, you know, many of those artists have lost relevance, or have lost, you know, something in their, have lost ability, you know what I'm saying, for whatever reason. And I just occupy a super unique space in that I haven't lost relevance. I've been able to reinvent myself, you know, a couple times, you know, throughout my career, and it served a great purpose in that. And yeah, so I'm aware of that. And, you know, I think, you know, all those things are part of the responsibility that I take into consideration as sort of a, you know, a holder of the torch, right? Mm-hmm. Me as an emcee, and the Roots as a band, you know, as one of the last bastions of black, you know, bandmanship, right? You know, it's not something that we take lightly, you know.
But it's interesting. I mean, your name came to take on a real deep responsibility for what it says, black thought, or yeah, black identity,
yeah,
or giving meaning to black life.
That's just it, you know. Yeah, over time, my name has come to mean, you know, more than a name, you know, both to me and mm-hmm. to my fans. And, you know, the fact that my name is Black Thought, I think, is just the icing on the cake. I think, mm-hmm. again, my music would probably be, you know, the same, even if I call myself something different. Mm-hmm. But I don't think any other name would be more fitting, mm-hmm. you know?